Good morning, children. Welcome back to the online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Vattakara.
Dear children, welcome back to the history class. Did you remember last class up to where we completed? Okay, and did you complete the notes? And what about that? Did you understand the lesson? Any doubt? Okay, then please you have to complete the note then and there itself and to study. I hope all of you studied that answers very well. Now we can start the second part of this lesson. But last class we discussed what is nationalism and what are the differences between nation state and modern state and what were the measures accepted by the French revolutionaries to spread their ideas. And the last question we discussed, the Napoleonic Code or the Civil Code of 1804. Then, now today's class, we can discuss the condition of Europe in middle 18th century. I hope all of you know that the present Europe entirely different from the middle 18th century. Listen, the present day, the European nations, they turned to be as an independent nations. But earlier, middle 18th century, then these were under the control of autocratic powers. Okay, then that we wanted to discuss here today's class. There were no nation state. These states were divided into different cantons, duchies and kingdoms. And the rulers of these kingdoms, they had autonomous powers or the territories. Understood? Then next, Eastern and Central Europe that were under the control of monarchies, they lived diverse people. In this or under one monarchy, there lived different types of people and they did not share a collective identity or a common culture. And they spoke different languages and belonged to different ethnic groups. An example, the Austro-Habsburg Empire that included Austria, Hungary and patchwork of many other different regions and people. And then please see the chart. Listen, the Habsburg Empire included the Alpine region, Sudetenland, Austria, then Bohemia and Austria-Hungary. But like this, the different regions under one empire. And they used different languages. They did not follow the same language. Example, in Galicia, the aristocracy, they spoke Polish. And in Hungary, half of the population, they spoke Magyar. And while other half, they spoke a variety of dialects. And it included the Italian speaking provinces of Lombardy and Venetia. Understood? In this region, various language people, they used the different languages like Polish, Magyar and as well as the Italian languages. So, there was no unity among the people of this region. And the Habsburg Empire that also included the peasants' communities like Bohemians and Slovaks to the north. Then Croats to the south and Romans to the east, etc. Did you clear? These differences that did not create a sense of collective identity. The only thing that created unity among the people that was a common allegiance to the empire. That means these diverse people, they were under one empire. Understood? Then next we wanted to discuss the characteristics of aristocracy. Aristocracy, they were the dominant class. They were so powerful and they were united by a common way of life that cut across the different regions. Did you understand? Then they were very less in number, but among them there was a unity. They owned estates in the countryside and townhouses, and they spoke French for the purpose of diplomacy and high status in the society. They wanted to be so. Then powerful in the society, so they used which language only? The French only. Then their families were often connected by ties of marriage. Clear? These were the characteristics of aristocracy in Europe. Please see that one. Okay, but they were very less in number. The majority of the population, they were peasants. Understood? Okay, see that the common characteristics of the peasants. Peasants were more in numbers, but the powers were enjoyed by the aristocracy. The next one, please see the chart. Listen, characteristics of aristocracy. And to the western part, the large land areas that was farmed by the tenants and small owners, land owners. In eastern and central Europe, vast estates were cultivated by serfs. Clear? To the western Europe or the western European countries, large land areas was farmed by tenants and small owners. But at the same time, in eastern and central Europe, the vast estates were cultivated by serfs. Understood? Then, next please listen, the effects of industrialization. How did industrialization that affect the Europeans during this period? Do you know? Industrialization that first of all occurred in where? In 18th century in England, and gradually that spread to other European countries also. Here in western and central parts of Europe, the growth of industrial production and trade that meant the growth of towns and the new commercial classes. Please listen, due to the industrialization, there emerged new classes as well as the new towns. There emerged or developed new towns. Then, due to industrialization, new social groups also emerged. New social groups like middle class and the working class. Among this middle class, they spread the ideas of national unity and abolition of the aristocratic privileges. Listen, due to the emergence of new middle class people, that was due to industrialization, then there was a spread of unity among these middle class people, and they started to turn against the aristocracy or the privileges enjoyed by the first and second estate. Okay, did you clear? Please see the chart. Okay, the effects of industrialization in Europe. New social class emerged, commercial class, working class, as well as the middle class. And then they started to turn against the aristocratic privileges. Clear? And they worked for the unity of the nation. First, we discussed that European nations were divided into different duchies, cantons and kingdoms. And these middle class people, they started to unite these nations under one empire. Did you clear? I hope all of you understood. Okay, now I am stopping here and you have to write the questions. I will send the questions. Please, then if any doubt you have to clear, don't forget that. Thank you.